Trixie. Trixie, we gotta go now. Where are you, girl? Come on, Trixie. Where are you? Hey, sweetheart. You live around here? Have you seen my dog? It's a little white terrier. It's got black spots around its eyes.
No.
Oh, boy, well, we're up here working, and this big Labrador came along, and they ran off together, and I've looked everywhere.
I have a Labrador.
A light brown Labrador? Mm-hmm. Did you see it play with the little white terrier?
No.
No? Are you sure? What's your dog's name?
Elvis.
Elvis, that's a good name. My dog's name's Trixie. You think they could be playing in your backyard?
Yeah.
Is your mommy home?
She's at work.
Yeah? Well, I bet they're up there right now tearing up your dad's flower bed. Can we go take a look? Real quick? Come on. Come on, honey.
Hello, Elvis.
Hey, Elvis. Have you seen Trixie? Trixie! Come here, Trixie! Come here, girl! Thanks a lot for helping me look for her. I'm going to check the pound. She's probably there. She can be a bad dog sometimes, you know? Are you on your way to school?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, great. I'm making you late. I'm sorry. What school do you go to?
St. Andrews.
St. Andrews. I went to St. Andrews. Over on Hoover? Well, come on. I'll give you a ride. Come on in. We'll get there lickety-split. Come on. Why didn't you say so? What did you say your name once again?
Leslie.
Leslie, I'm Alex. This is Frank. Oh, St. Andrews. I tell you. Does Mrs. Williams still teach music there? With that bright red hair. She's probably pretty old now. She used to play the tuba really bad. Yeah. This is your lucky day, Leslie, because I showed you a shortcut I used to take when I was late for school. What'd you say your last name was?
Whitehead.
Is Mr. Whitehead your daddy? Oh my gosh, you're kidding me. We work for Mr. Whitehead. He's our boss.
At the water company?
Yes, at the water company. You know what? I've worked there almost as long as he has. I run errands for him sometime. I might have got your birthday present for you. Did you get a big doll for your birthday?
No.
Well, it's still something, isn't it, Frank? Huh? Well, I'm going to tell him I gave his daughter a ride to school, but I'm not going to say anything about making her late. Here we go. All right. Have a good one. Leslie, quick. We're going to give you a lift.
What?
Your daddy asked us to take you. There's been a problem at the water company.
I don't know.
They ain't there, honey.
Where are they?
Well, get in and I'll explain. Come on, Leslie, get in the car. Your daddy's in some trouble. He had to leave Wilmington right away.
Where's my mom?
She went with him. She went straight from work.
Why didn't they take me?
Because they asked us to, because it was urgent. We're going to take you to him. So come on, let's go. Okay, we're going to take you to him. Don't worry.
They wait for me. I don't understand.
Well, it all happened so quickly. Your dad called me at the office and said to pick you up. He's in a little bit of trouble, but it's nothing serious, so don't worry about it. Just eat your hamburger and drink your drink, and we'll get you back to him in no time.
Come on. Drink it. Do you have a phone call to make, Alex?
Well, that's right. Anyone sees a payphone, holler. Yes, she's with us now, and everything is fine. Okay. Okay, that's not a problem. We'll hear from you then, Mr. Whitehead. Okay, thank you. Bye now. I was your daddy and he said everything is A-okay. He's going to call us later.
When am I going home?
Soon. Now drink up your drink, honey.
It's warm.
I'll tell you what. You drink all that one and I'll get you an ice cold one next.
Come on, drink it up.
Where are we?
All right, folks, it's bath time. Okay, let's get undressed to jump in. Come on, it's just a bath, it's not gonna bite. I'm shy too. Hey, you gotta rub it harder if you want to get it clean, right? Nobody likes little boys with dirty hair. Did Leslie tell you that she has a dog named Elvis? Hey, he's a yellow Labrador. Right, honey?
Where's Trixie?
Who's, who?
Your dog, Trixie.
Oh, Trixie. Well, Frank went back there to look for her, and, he looked at all the pounds, and he couldn't find her, so I guess she's lost. Poor Trixie. She shouldn't have run off like that. Excuse me. Hello. Mr. Whitehead. It's Alex. Yes, she's fine. So, how long? You sure? Okay, but hold on a second. I'm ready to.
Right?
Okay, I guess I'll hear from you then. Okay.
They don't want her back yet.
Hey, how's your hair? You want to wash?
I don't believe you. I don't believe you. What have I done wrong?
Nothing.
I want to call them. I want to speak to them. They want to leave me.
You can. You can. I have your dad's cell phone number. You can. We'll take care of you. Me and Frank, and so will Donnie, won't you, Donnie? We're gonna look out for you. So don't worry. It's all gonna work out.
I wanna speak to them.
Well, of course you do. So why don't you keep their phone number and you can call them back anytime you want. Okay? Now, Frank's gonna be back in a couple minutes with some new clothes for you. Let's say our prayers. Lord, bless this food for which we are about to receive. We are ever so grateful. I bless this house and all of us in it. And look out for Donnie's mom. We hope she gets well soon. And bless Leslie's parents and help them get through this troubling time so they may return to her. Amen.
Cookie, huh? Is that what I said? No, I didn't tell you to eat it. For fuck's sake. Neither of you. You fucking don't listen. Neither of you. I'm gonna let you know a little secret, huh? Your mama and dada, they don't want you anymore. They haven't called. They haven't written. Seems like they're pretty happy without the both of you.
Sometimes, you know, things are very strange. And no matter how hard you try, you can never understand them or why they've done this to you. Maybe Frank was right. For whatever reason, maybe for your mommy and daddy, life was hard. And things go wrong for them, and suddenly you're gone, and who knows why, but their life gets a little bit easier. Now, your daddy, he used to leave here for a few days, right? Your mom said it was for business. But he didn't even have time to buy your birthday presents for you, remember? Remember? I got them for you, right? Well, my daddy was like that, too. I remember this one time, he'd been away on a long trip, and he came home, and that night we stayed up all night playing games, and he read to me, and I remember thinking, this is the greatest night of my life. And then he said, I have to go buy a pack of cigarettes, but don't worry, because I'll be right back. And he never came back, and I never saw my daddy again. I know how you feel, honey. I know that I could never be your daddy or be anything like him or take his place. But I could be like an uncle. Uncle Alex. Okay. Get some rest.
Some girls are crying, man. She looks like shit. So you're Alex's little girl now, huh? Alex's favorite little girl.
And you are my favorite little boy.
Just drive the car.
Good friend of ours. He's gonna look after you for a while, okay? I want you to do whatever he asks. Okay?
She understands. Don't worry about it. She's fine.
All right. We'll see you in a bit.
All we want to do is have a little fun, Leslie. Could be fun for you, too. Have you ever...
clean your daddy's shoes each when you get a dollar? Did you do nothing like that? Mow the lawn? Clean the car? I guess that's what little boys do. Mow the lawn and clean the car.
You see, if you work at something, it pays off. If you work like you're supposed to, like you would at school. Only instead of good grades, you get money. You pull in enough money, you ain't got to live on the streets. And you don't want to do that. The streets is where the devils live. The streets, you get lost forever. Do is okay. It's beautiful. Is it me? Is it color of my skin? That ain't nothing to be fighting over if it was just the same as yours. You want to touch him?
Nothing wrong with that either. Did you know that? That's been kept a secret from you. I bet you everybody knows except for you.
Nothing wrong with touching.
Everybody does it. Teacher does it. Doctors do it.
The police officers do it.
Everybody does it. Even your daddy does it. Your daddy touches me. If you stayed home, pretty soon, he'd have been touching you.
No.
What?
No.
Hey, 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 get out of here. Sit down. Shut up. I hear me talking to you. I'm trying to be nice to you, bitch.
There to protect you? Huh? And nothing's ever gonna happen to you because I won't let it.
Hey! This is murder, man! This is fucking murder! We're all involved in this, all three of
us! It's okay, Frank, because no one saw us! All we gotta do is stick together and support each other!
Shit! Fuck!
You know, luckily we all are a part of something really terrible now. But if we help each other, and we stand by each other, then everything's gonna be okay. You understand? So I'm not gonna tell anybody, and you're not gonna tell anybody, are you? No. Don't worry. It's okay, honey. Shh. That's the old you, honey. You're just leaving it behind. That's all, honey. Shh. It's just like the caterpillar. He has to shed his skin to become the beautiful butterfly. Shh. And you don't think that hurts the caterpillar? Well, of course it does, honey. But it's the only way he can become a beautiful butterfly. And that's what you're becoming. Something really, really beautiful, honey. Leslie, I think you're beautiful. Leslie, I would never hurt you. I would never hurt you, honey. Shh. It's okay, honey. It's okay now. It's okay. Shh. You've got me. Got me, honey. It's all fine. It's all fine. I'm so proud of you.
Something is coming uphill, said Mother Wolf, twitching one ear. Get ready. The bushes rustled a little in the thicket, and Father Wolf dropped ready for his leap. Man, he snapped. A man's cub. Look! Directly in front of him, holding a low branch, stood a naked brown baby who could just walk. As soft and as dimpled, a little atom as ever came to a wolf's cave at night. He looked up into Father Wolf's face and laughed. Is that a man's cub? Said Mother Wolf. I had never seen one before. Bring it here. How little, how naked, and how bold, said Mother Wolf softly. The baby was pushing his way between the cubs to get closer to the warm hide. He is taking his meal with the others. He looks like a frog, said Father Wolf. Then that's what we'll call him, Mowgli the Frog. We should make secret names for each other. I could be Mowgli, and you could be Wolf.
And who are they?
They are the monkey people.
Mowgli's lost in the jungle, and Wolf has to find me and protect me from the evil, crazy monkeys. And this is our jungle, and nobody can come into it.
It was at the old woman's. She made me a cake, a chocolate cake. It had 5 candles on it.
Why'd you run away from home?
My mom went crazy. She said she wanted to talk to dogs in a library.
What about your dad?
He lives in a van somewhere.
Where's your mom?
They put her in a hospital.
Is that where she sold you?
Do you have any pictures like that?
I don't.
It's okay. I can take some. Then they go in the book. The book gets sent all over the country. I sent it by FedEx. If they get picked, they're going to be flown to the client, or sometimes the client flies to you. If the kids fly, I go with them. I arrange the ID, and the split is an even 50-50. It's profitable and safe.
Safe, that's good.
It's important.
Yeah.
We give partner discounts, so if there's any...
Oh, no, I don't.
Hmm?
I'm not like that.
No, me neither.
Okay.
So, cute kids, but...
Yeah. Yeah.
Adorable.
They are. Really? See, I don't want my kids flying either.
Okay.
Hey.
Okay. Maybe later.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
So, take a bath. Take the bath first. They like that. Remember, that's a free tip. Everything's going to be fine. You know where you're going? You're going to a judge's house. You know what that is? That's a good man. Judges are fair. They always do the right thing. So, whatever he wants, you do. If a judge says it's okay, it's okay.
Listen, Mowgli, said Wolf. I have taught you all the laws of the jungle for all the peoples of the jungle, except the monkey people who live in the trees. They have no laws. They are outcasts. They have no speech of their own, but use the stolen words they overhear when they listen and peer and wait up above in the branches.
You got dressed again. Why don't you, put this on instead.
Their way is not our way. They have no leaders. They have no memories. They boast and chatter and pretend they are great people about to do great things in the jungle.
Who's this?
Oh, a friend of mine, Jimmy, dropped by to say hello. He ran off to do an errand for me, so I said it was fine to leave. He's here.
Is he coming back soon?
Yes, he is.
What's your name?
Leslie.
Would you like to go upstairs and meet them? Girls, I want you to look after Leslie when she's picked up, okay? Daddy and I will come and kiss you goodnight later.
like everything's gone all fun.
You tripping over there, Donnie?
Everything seems so slow.
Yeah, that's about right.
Back.
What?
Ice cream is gone. Ice cream. Oh, it's gone.
So what if the ice cream's gone?
It's that shit.
Round up the moment.
Hey, don't bust your bridges.
You just don't have a sweet tooth like I do, that's all.
Yeah, just don't let it get to me like you do, that's all. Honey? Would you like some ice cream? Yeah? What about you, Donnie? You want some ice cream? Well, then let's go to the store and get some ice cream. Who wants a piggyback ride?
100 kinds of ice cream, one for every night of the year. How many can you name, Leslie?
Strawberry. We got a butter pecan. We got a vanilla bean. We got all kinds of chocolate. Dark chocolate, light chocolate, mint chocolate. Strawberry, raspberry, blueberry. We got Neapolitan, which is all three together. That's one of my favorites. And then we got the crunchy road, crunchy crunch, butter brickle,
It's $7.95.
Keep the change. There you go. Thank you.
Let's go.
This is how you hide. Look at the way it's in.
I'll share, but I got more kids over on the road. That's my favorite crunchy crunch in here with your dad.
Secret. Frank, outside. Outside.
Shit.
Just stay the fuck away from me.
Calm down, sir.
Don't you touch me, Alex.
Calm down. You better take care of it, okay?
What are you gonna do?
I'll figure out something. Just calm down.
Every single thing I have.
You're all nervous this day.
Well,
yes. This is good. This is all the good stuff.
Everything.
Okay, you don't
know that. Well, you know what? You got a bonus. All right?
Oh, shit.
I give you the money.
Okay.
Right.
You ever get at that place right over there on the
Yeah.
That
place with the big Coca-Cola sign?
The next thing Mowgli remembered was feeling hands on his arms and legs, and then a swatch of branches in his face. And then he was staring down through the swaying tree limbs as the monkey people howled with triumph and scuffled him away to the upper branches. Then they began their long flight, and the flight of the monkey people through tree land is one of the things nobody can describe.
Let's make a promise, Donnie.
What promise?
We'll always be together. Always. If something happens and we can't be, we'll meet up someplace.
Okay. Where?
Here. We'll meet up there. At Wonderland. Okay?
Okay.
Is bringing back wonder to the USA.
So late. That's my sister right there.
Donnie, what the hell are you doing?
Now, I don't know what she's been saying to you, but she's a bit of a romantic. You know, flowers. margarita, soft music, you know, but if I can give you a bit of gossip, this 80 shit you got going on, man, it just ain't the taste. You don't like that stuff. So maybe you, maybe you should try something else. Come on, let's go.
Hey! What are you waiting for, Bert? Give me back my fucking phone!
What does that say?
Armaments.
What does that mean?
Guns, you know, guns, bombs, stuff guns? Like that.
Why did you say that then? Guns. Guns. I mean, I bet you a bunch of people are gonna get fucking caught up on that shit. Armaments.
We cannot enter into this war unprepared. It is vital that we know both the strength and size of their armaments.
Guns.
But, brother, any such action...
Okay, now, you know, I'm in this fucking hospital, right? Laying in bed, tubes out of my arms and shit. It's fucking crazy. You know, this other guy, he was all shrunk up. Covered. Me.
Excuse me, sir. Hey, can I just shoot a bar? We got cheap drinks, we got straight business, we got the best live sex acts in town. We got lesbians, we got fucking everything. You know, the best part is, you don't have to pay. You can just sit there and you can watch. I mean, come on, think about it. We got young girls, we got little chickens, come on! Can you spare some change?
All right, man, how much do you want for that phone?
I don't know, like 100, 120.
Are you fucking serious? Come on, man, it's a nice phone. Shit, it's hot. Oh, man. I'll catch you at the boardwalk. I'm
scared of you, fool. Yeah, you're afraid that girl's gonna get one of those cars. She's not gonna come back.
Yeah. Is that good, baby?
Everything all right?
I'm almost
done. Shit, girl, come here.
Hey, we'll talk to you afterwards, right? Stay close. What's up? How's it going?
Hey, Cooper, it's going okay.
Hey, I got that date for you on that airline highway. You still on it?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, you still with that kid?
Yeah.
What the fuck do you hang out with him for, huh? Does he got the guy mapped to your life? I don't think so.
Yeah, but you do.
Listen, baby, friends are just people who haven't fucked you over yet. Look, you sure you're okay? You don't look so good.
I'm fine.
Here. Take this. A gift.
Thanks.
Look at those fucking niggas, man. Remember Donna? Yeah, she's hanging out right over there. She's a lot like you, too. She wanted to be independent. Anyway. One day there was this gang of nigga pills from Oceanside. Driving by, saw her, they liked her, so they fucking grabbed her right off the fucking street, man. You ever think why they like working with white girls? Huh? It gets them the white money. It's a real fuck you. Hey, listen. I want to show you something. Come with me. Shelter on India Street? How'd you feel about going there and bringing her out?
To you?
Yeah. But first I want you to turn her. And then you bring her to me.
I'm not a fucking booster, lady.
I know that, but it doesn't take any special skills, right? I mean, you tell her how I'm gonna help her, and then you break her in. Let her watch you do it a couple of times. You know how it goes. Hey, I'm offering you something pretty great here. I know you. I know that when you close your eyes, you see something better. I can set you up with some people I know. You won't have to scrounge around for hotel room money anymore. Okay? Think about it.
Hey, I got you this.
Oh, my God.
Hey.
Thank you.
No problem. So what did Cooper want?
Nothing.
So he just gave you this?
He likes me.
Yeah, well, he's an asshole. How's that?
He's okay. He just gets uptight sometimes.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Got some pork? I'll take him if I can use him one, okay?
Every night.
Stay up. So if you want to sleep, let's go.
So bad you don't know what to do. Well, feel this. It's so wet. Oh, I can feel it. Oh, I can feel it. It's so big rubbing up and down. It's so big. It's almost too big. Oh, come on, baby. Fuck me. Come on.
Fuck me. Come on, spit it into me. Come on, spit. Spit. Come on, let it explode. Oh, my God, let it explode so hard it's gonna shoot out my throat. Oh, my God, I'm gonna come. I'm gonna come. I'm gonna come. And then they do.
32 seconds. Shoot out my throat? I gotta use that. You really have to say all that?
I remember this one time. I had this Chinese guy. He had a small one. Very small. We're talking teensy-weensy here, okay? And he goes, you like my big dick? My real big dick? And he paid me like an extra $100 just to keep saying that. I did like his big dick.
Why are guys so into the size of their dicks?
Well, because we are.
No, they're not. Not all of them anymore.
All I want to hear about is how big it is and how smooth it is and how good it feels going
in. No, I do the same stuff you guys do, and I don't say that shit to them, and they don't say that shit to me.
Well, maybe you're not like a great conversationalist, Donnie.
What the fuck is that? Just some big-ass word?
Just means that you're not into talking.
No, we talk. We just don't talk that stuff.
What do you talk about?
Fuck you.
Football. Man.
Football and politics. That's what we talk about. Leave all that dirty shit up to you girls. You know, Rap was thinking about going over to Fort Lauderdale. You know, maybe we should go along with him.
Why?
Well, there's that carny that starts up in March and it travels up and down all year. You know, maybe we can get a job working the rides or the hot dog stand or popcorn or something like that. I met some friends with it last time they seen that thing. I really like that. I don't know, I thought it'd be kind of cool.
I'm tired of moving.
Well, you want to just settle down and get a house and a pool and a dog and the whole thing?
Dog would be okay.
Yeah, dog would be nice.
Did you sell that phone yet?
No, Rap Boy's got it.
Donnie, how long does it take to sell a fucking phone?
I told you Rap Boy's going to take care of it. I'm just waiting on him.
You don't care, do you, if we sleep out on the beach in the park, do you?
You ever think about Alex and Frank and that whole thing?
No.
Never.
I don't think about it.
I do. I know it sounds weird, but you know, without them, we would have never met, you know? You don't have to do anything to me, and I'm not going to do anything to you. Anybody can have that part.
old are you, Leslie?
18. I'm nearly 17.
And both your parents are dead?
Yes.
I'm sorry, that must be very hard for you. How old were you when they died?
7, 8.
And did you go to live with relatives who looked after you?
An uncle. We stayed with an uncle.
And we who is we?
My brother.
And where is the uncle now?
I don't know.
And your brother now?
I don't know.
Have you ever stayed in a shelter?
Just walk-ins, never for the night.
All right, Leslie, well, here it is. No drugs or alcohol in this building or in the recreational yard. If you're caught with them in your possession, you're out, and no amount of tears or pleading or excuses will change that. If you have to smoke, you do it outside, not in this building, okay? You're free to come and go during the day, but those doors are locked at 9 o'clock at night, and they are not reopened till 8 in the morning. The shelter is here to help you. It's here to help you stop taking drugs, to help you stop prostituting yourself, and to help you stop killing yourself. You understand that? You came in here to get away from something, but you leave that something outside, all right? Understand?
Yes.
Don't bring it in here.
Okay.
Good.
They're gonna send me to a foster home. Soda home. Everything's got another name. Sweet Mac. Player. Gorilla. Meat dealer. Just another name for somebody who wants to make money off of you. Strawberry. Somebody who lets them. What you gotta do is make your own family. Somebody who'll keep an eye open when you wanna close yours. These places are no better. Selling dope in the kitchen. They let the Johns in at night, keep the money for themselves. You may as well keep the money for yourself. The whole world's doing it, and you might as well know it. How old are you?
12.
Bad man, you know. Nice sea breeze, pleasant night.
How much?
Oh man, you couldn't afford me. I'm just too expensive for you.
All right. Fuck you, punk.
Hey, wait, man. Man, fuck you. You can't take a fucking joke. Laugh about it, motherfucker. Fuck you.
Cooper, who I was telling you about.
You're a beautiful girl, you know that, right? Yeah. Lady's gonna take care of you, okay? I've been waiting for you for a long time, you know. Did you know that? My suit is nice enough to come get you, but we're gonna work something out, all right?
You're sure that this is the right thing to do?
Yeah, why?
I just feel scared.
Hey, it's gonna be okay.
Wait.
You know what this is like? It's like when a caterpillar becomes a butterfly. You think that doesn't hurt? That's the only way to become a butterfly. And that's you. You're gonna become something beautiful. Hey, don't worry. I'm gonna look out for you, okay?
Where's Leslie?
What?
Where the fuck is he? You know what I'm talking about. Where's Leslie?
Man, get the fuck away.
Fuck you!
Listen, asshole. Man, I didn't do anything with her, alright? She went, and she wanted to go. What?
Fuck you.
What?
You're fucking lying, man.
What, you thought she was gonna hang around with you the rest of her fucking life?
Fuck you, you're a fucking liar.
Her own fucking words, man. She had a chance to move up, and you're a fucking deadweight. You're a fuck-up.
Fuck.
Fuck you!
Come on, Cooper, let go!
What?
Oh, baby, yeah. Come on. I'm gonna come.
Tell me. Tell me, little girl.
Just come. Why don't you come? Just fucking come. Come on. Come on, just fucking come. Why can't you come?
Get the fuck off me then! I don't need this shit. Fucking crazy bitch. And fuck you then! Fuck you!
Thank you.
You're my girl now. And that's our secret.
Right? Get to that shit right fucking now. Get there. Fuck. Hey, Kristen, you fucking faggot. Where is Leslie? Where is that bitch? Man, I swear to fucking God, where is that?
Be out of your fucking mind. You remember Surf? You want to end up dead in a toilet too?
Just remember Donnie.
Donnie? Donnie's long gone, honey. He left town with Rat Boy.
He left town? When did he go?
I don't know, but they're long gone. Just get the fuck out of here yourself, okay?
Wait. Did he say where he was going?
Yeah, to find America.
Leslie, let me ask you. Do you really think both your parents are dead, your mom and your dad? Do you really believe that? Were you still living at home when they died?
No.
And how do you know they're dead?
I heard it.
You heard it? Where did you hear it? Hmm? All right. And where is home to you? Leslie, where is that?
I don't remember.
I think we all remember home. You know what I think? I think you left. Maybe because you wanted to. Maybe you didn't. Maybe you had to. And I think you left so long ago that now you have no idea how to go back. Just like you don't know how to tell your parents that you're not dead. Just like you can't even admit to yourself that your parents aren't dead. Right? Why can't you admit that, Leslie?
They fucking didn't want me. They left me and they never came back to get me. And I heard them on the phone and they kept saying soon and then they never came.
I would imagine you heard one side of a conversation. You know how many kids I've had in here over the years who heard one end of a telephone conversation? One side of a call where the other side is only a dial tone? You know how many? A lot.
Hey,
What's wrong? It looks to me like they want you.
I couldn't go back. They don't want me. They wouldn't want me now. I've done too many things. They don't want me.
Wish you could go back. Of course they would want me.
You don't understand. They wouldn't want me.
Leslie, it's time for you to go home.
So Leslie, there's something that you have to know. Your mother and I wanted to be the ones to tell you. You have a brother and a sister.
What do you mean?
Well, after you, we had two more children.
Where are they?
They're at a friend's. We wanted to see you first.
Do they know about me?
Of course. Of course they do.
Well, what'd you tell them?
We told them that, they had a beautiful older sister who we love very much and who had gone to heaven.
Is that what you thought? You thought I died?
No, we
never stopped hoping. Never, never.
Leslie. I want you to come home. This is Dylan.
This is Gracie. This is your sister. Hi.
Did you come back from heaven?
No.
Where did you come back from?
I was in a forest.
What forest?
It was far away.
What were you doing there?
I was lost.
Were you scared?
Sometimes.
Why?
Because there were monsters in the forest.
Hey, you know, tell you what, why don't we all go in the dining room and then you guys can show Leslie the really great cake that Mommy made especially for her, okay? Hey!
It's yummy. Mama says it's your favorite.
Did you get it? In your hand? Did you catch it? Excellent. Is it glittery? Look at that.
Scared doing stuff like this. Just have to have somebody to look out for you. That's all.
And this is our jungle. And nobody can come into it. Come back, she whispered. Come back, for I love you. Come back again, by night or by day. This door is never shut to you. Mowgli's throat worked as though the cords in it were being pulled, and his voice seemed to be dragged from it as he answered, "I will surely come back."